A bill establishing the Bulacan Special Economic Zone and Freeport and creating the Bulacan Special Economic Zone and Freeport Authority has lapsed into law on June 13. Now it's official. Under the law, the Bulacan Special Economic Zone and Freeport will be known as the Bulacan Eco Zone or BUZZ, which will cover the airport project and the airport city project of San Miguel's Ramon Ang. Well, the Bulacan Special Economic Zone and Freeport Authority, or BEZA, will manage the BUZZ. The BEZA shall be organized within 180 days upon the effectivity of the law, which will take effect 15 days following the completion of its publication in the Official Gazette or a newspaper of general circulation. Aside from threats of maritime aggression, Filipino fishermen are also struggling with depleting fish supply in Philippine seas. Jackie Pascual reports.
Philippine Agriculture Secretary and former fishing tycoon Francisco T. Laurel Jr. raises the alarm over the country's fish supply. He warns fish stocks have dwindled due to overexploitation.
Unfortunately, I have to say, we have to relax or reduce fishing effort. Dahil talagang depleted na, destroyed and over-exploited. No, but of course, it's not the commercial lang may kasalanan yan. And I think it's everybody who, you know, even the municipal, the coastal, dynamite fisher, cyanide fisher, lahat yan eh.
Fishermen in Avota say they are seeing a steady decline in their catch.
Dati nakakadalawang daan timbami mahigit eh. Ngayon, 100 lang. Mahirap pong maging mangisda. Wala na pong mahuli, may nanghuli pa.
The Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources say studies have shown signs of overfishing in some fishing grounds in the country. As part of conservation measures, the agency implements closed fishing seasons during the year-end to allow fish to repopulate.
Ang iba sa ating mga fishing grounds dito sa Pilipinas ay nagpapakita na ng senyales ng overfishing. Concerning ito kasi kailangan sustainable yung utilization ng ating fisheries resources. At kung may nakikita tayo na mga senyales ng overfishing, kailangan po tugunan natin ito.
The Agri-Chief says one illegal fishing method that affects fish supplies is the use of nets with very small holes. Fisher Folk Groups Pamalakaya says destructive practices such as reclamation also lead affect fish supplies. Meanwhile, Q. Laurel said he will be blacklisting 4 companies involved in smuggling, including 2 companies in fisheries. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Banco Central kept key rates unchanged for a 6th straight meeting at 6.5% as expected, but said an August easing remains on track with inflation seen cooling further. BSP Governor Elia de Molona cites government's slashing of tariffs on imported rice as a big driver, with a balance of risks to inflation outlook now tilted to the downside. The BSP lowered its CPI forecast to 3.1% for this year and the next. The figure well within government's 2-4% target range. Governor Remolona adds they're pricing in a total of 50 basis point cut this year that would put the BSP ahead of the U.S. Federal Reserve in cutting rates.
The Monetary Board anticipates price pressures to ease further in the second half of the year. If sustained, an improvement in the inflation outlook would allow more scope to consider a less restrictive monetary policy stance.
I think we're likely to reduce by 25 basis points at a time. So if we follow the course where we think we are, that would mean 25 basis points in the third quarter and then 25 in the fourth quarter.
Meanwhile, the governor also reaffirmed the central bank's commitment to defend the peso from sharp depreciations. The BSP intervened yesterday to prevent the currency, already down 5% so far this year, from hitting a new 20-month low on Thursday. The peso closing stronger at 58.75 against the greenback from the previous day's finish of 58.86.